everyone, Alana here from Masara Community Farm, and today we're making a massaged kale winter salad. Really simple. We're gonna roast a bunch of root vegetables that we happen to have at the farm. You can do this with pretty much any root vegetables, but so we've got baby potatoes, we've got some kohlrabi, which is essentially like a mix between broccoli stem and an apple and a radish. Super sweet carrot, beets, baby beets, and some baby sweet potatoes. But of course, you can get full size, whatever you got. I'm pretty much just gonna chop them into similarly sized pieces so that we can roast them all at the same time. So you wanna be able to get like one single layer and you want everything to be pretty equally sized. So let's chop. I'll never peel a carrot. I think the skin is probably good for you. If you're gonna eat kohlrabi raw, I would probably peel it because the skin is awfully tough. You can also peel it if you want to, but when you roast it, it gets pretty soft. It doesn't really matter. What else? Beets as well. You can roast a beet, put it in tin foil, throw it in the oven, no oil, no anything. Depending on the size of the beet, cook it for like 20 minutes to 40 minutes. And once it's cool, the skin just comes right off. Because these are so tiny and because I wanna roast everything together, I am gonna peel the beets.
Nice.
I won't peel anything else. The potatoes, you know, barely need to be broken down. Also, just a side note, look at these beautiful potatoes from the farm.
Wow, I'm gonna zoom in. I don't
know. Chop, chop, chop.
What winter vegetable are you most excited about?
Ooh, impossible question, but I will actually say carrots because I'm obsessed with overwintered carrots, which is essentially when you put them in the ground earlier, let them come to size, and then you just let them sit through the winter. And in order to keep from freezing, they convert their starches into sugars. So come, you know, ground coming unfrozen, you know, February, March-ish, you harvest them and they're just like extra sweet, which is the carrots I'm using right now. And when you roast them, they get even sweeter. I think that the answer to winter blues is root vegetables, honestly, what we're doing right now. Delicious, chock full of nutrients, seasonal, so they're fresher. And really easy, honestly, like when in doubt, roast or cook down and puree into a soup. Like there's so many really easy things you can do with them. And there's something very cozy, I think, about like curling up with a bunch of roasted root vegetables. So we've got our vegetables. They are all roughly the same size. Doesn't need to be exact, but now we're gonna season them.
Ooh, they're so pretty. Can you believe we grew those?
I truly cannot. So we're gonna keep it really simple, salt, pepper, and just some olive oil. Enough to coat them. What an eyeball, do a glug. So let's do a little bit. And then you can really season these however you like. I definitely always suggest salt and pepper. Some other good ideas. I will often use like a little bit of garlic powder, maybe herb de Provence, which is just like a mix of dried, I think it's like rosemary and basil, thyme. So really any dried herbs that you like. You can make it spicy, you know, whatever. We've got the oven preheated to 425 and gonna wanna roast them for, it's probably gonna be a total of like 20-25 minutes, depending on how small you cut everything. But I like to give it 15, bring them out, you know, see how soft they are and kind of mix them around so they're getting like evenly cooked. Spread these guys out. Remember you want a single layer so they cook evenly. And let's get these in the oven. So after about, let's say it was about 25 minutes, they shrink up really nice, nice and soft, but I still like them to have like a little bit of a crunch, so I cook them to my liking. So we're gonna let those cool, and in the meantime, gonna start to make, we're gonna prepare our kale. For the kale, personally, you know, you could layer the leaves and chop them. I like to just pull them apart, and a lot of recipes will tell you to take the stems out, which you totally can do. I'm going to just to get kind of like a similar texture throughout, but the stems are actually really good and there's a lot of nutrients in them. So I would suggest if you like them, actually, let's keep some in. Nice crunch.
You could also, one thing I sometimes do is set them aside for later, and then I add them to, like, my next batch of roast vegetables because they roast up real nice,
oh,
too.
Oh, the stems. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. So, I've got my kale. I would always suggest putting a little bit more than you think you're going to need because once you massage it, it comes down a lot in size. Mm. So to massage it, I'm going to put like the tiniest amount of oil. I always end up putting too much, which is fine. Kale can kind of handle it. It's pretty hearty. But I will always try to start with like a drop. See what that does. But it's always less than you think. And then I'll do like a little bit of salt. And we're literally just gonna massage it. You can see it's already like, that was like, you know, 5 seconds. It's already pretty well reduced. And looks a little bit wet. I'm gonna keep going. And you can massage it kind of as much or as little as you want. Like, this reduced by about half, right? So I could add more if I wanted to. But let's leave it at that for now. And then we're gonna make a little dressing. So technically half your dressing is already in here, right? You have the olive oil. So you could just add a little bit of a vinegar. I like apple cider, but again, you can kind of use whatever. Or another acid, any form of acid. So I like to do a lemon, just squeeze a lemon in, really simple olive oil lemon, nice and bright. But today I want to show you how to make a really easy salad dressing. It's my favorite one. I always make it. And all you need is olive oil, some form of acid. Again, I'm gonna use apple cider vinegar today, and some mustard. I like to use Dijon because it has a little kick to it, but you can use any kind that you like. You know, a small scoop of mustard. I typically start with whatever spoon I'm using. I'll use that to measure out the vinegar, and then I'll start with, so let's say we use 3 spoonfuls worth. I'm gonna start with an equal amount of oil. One way I really like to test out my salad dressings is just taking a piece of the salad that I'm gonna use. Give it a little. Tastes pretty good. I am gonna add a little. Just eyeball it. I think seasoning your salad is really important, and something that I didn't used to do, I would just put dressing on. I'm gonna add a little bit of dressing at a time. And just give it a little mix. If your hands are clean and you don't mind mixing with your hands, I really like to because I think it helps get everything like perfectly coated without being overcoated or undercoated. Got my veggies that I'm just gonna throw on top. And there you go.
Yum.
Massage kale salad with roasted vegetables.
Oh, yummy. That looks so good.
And now we're going to go and eat this. So thanks so much for watching. Have a great day.
Bye.
Bye.